The album was recorded in Neptune's kitchen, which is the name of my home recording studio. Neptune is the one of the gods of music, and the kitchen is somewhere you cook something up. Well, actually, my wife was expecting a baby, and I think instinctively we wanted to head back to our roots so I could record the album and change nappies at the same time. I didn't choose the collaborators, they kind of chose me in a sense, especially with Alan Griffiths. He said to me, do you fancy doing some writing together? And I thought, no, I don't. The last thing I need is to, you know, get involved with anybody, you know, when I was in a sense going through a former divorce. Well, I said, oh yeah, okay.
I played guitar on the 1985 world tour with Tears for several months, so we've known each other for quite a considerable amount of time. Roland kind of used to call me up from time to time, and we used to go out and we used to discuss things, and I used to play him bits and pieces that I was working on.
Can you go from just before the first chorus?
I can. That was just before the first chorus.
Yeah, I know, but
okay,
I wasn't ready.
The day he came up to London, bought all his gear, set it all up, started jamming, and it was like, wow. Regarding Tim Palmer, I mean, what happened there was really, I felt we needed a third person just to be the objective one, as Alan and I were doing most of the creativity. We just listened to a lot of records, and we felt that Tim Palmer's were the best sounding.
All right. Yeah, I was fine. Al was terrible.
We experimented with him, working with him on Laid So Low, got on with him well, and asked him to do the album.
I'll tell you what, at the end,
okay. What was nice about this record was the fact that we stripped it right back to just being three musicians in a studio. We wanted to keep it very much the three of us and the engineer Mark as well. So it was just literally four people in the studio the whole time, really. We didn't bring any outside session players in at all. I think it's a lot more human and a lot more emotional for that.
Tim, turn down the offbeat snares.
Elemental, the title track of the album, once again really emanated from a jam.
No.
I suppose it's like a play on the word mental, you know. It's all in the mind. These days it's all in the mind. It's mental, it's elemental.
Oh,
I think it's fair to say he has a very firm idea in his head how he wants ultimately see something. He can be sometimes... he's very critical of himself. I think that was one of the things that I tried to sort of loosen up a bit, because he does like to keep going until it's perfect.
When I get struck by an idea, it's like an obsession. And it my whole life is, you know, works around this obsession. I didn't want to write songs that people could so easily say, well, that's about that, and that's about that. I really wanted just to write words that kind of were ambivalent. Like magic create the future.
What makes a man so fickle? Who put
a lot of the time it was an atmosphere that was generating a lyric, and he could change that as it went along. But, you know, before we started vocals, he'd always make sure that we sat down and we wrote out all the lyrics, so we all were very conscious of what the song was about, particularly when choosing bits of vocal. You better love loving and you better behave.
Warmer than chains. Quite often I've been an agent of transformation in other people's life, like Aletta Adams, for instance. You know, I kind of came along, and the whole next phase of Tears for Fears was based around her. They were all personal songs. But I think I didn't realise that. Woman in Chains was really about my mum and dad, their relationship, that, you know, that power struggle. After like Woman in Chains, really, and all of Sowing Seeds of Love, and that kind of the spiritual element, you know, albeit I don't know how true it was, it is to what we were doing at the time, and Cold, you know, kind of is the answer, really. I think it's the follow-up to Woman in Chains, really. Cold. There was a young lady in Germany, a photographer, who I didn't realise was a big fan. When we did the gig, she was trying to take a lot of shots, but again, I was just like turning my face away. She sent me a note, and the note said, how come someone who writes such beautiful songs be so cold, you know? So that's where the title comes from.
Shall I work on the outro? Because there's more choruses there.
I think it's a mistake a lot of people make, is when they see me on TV, they think I'm a nice guy, when I'm really a bastard.
I think they sound like enough.
Definitely.
Okay.
I feel that somebody has got to counteract the kind of the stuff that we're sold so much, you know, by the media and television, all these beauty adverts and, you know, the youth-orientated society and all that kind of stuff, youth culture and everything is wonderful and everything's beautiful, and the whole thrust of advertising is to do with everything looking wonderful, you know, and life's not like that. So, you know, I mean, it, break it down again, it's like celebrating the fact that, you know, things do end, that there is a cycle to life. That's why one of the lines of the song is that they make no mention of the beauty of decay. And what else? Yeah, I mean, it's just, you know, everything in the universe is recyclable, including you.